Good morning, one and all. My name is Dr. B. Srinivasulu, Department of Mechanical Engineer. Today we are going to discuss about the metal cutting and machine tool. In that one, we are going for the cutting tool material. So before going to that, let me discuss about the what is actually the introduction part of metal cutting and machine tool. So we know that means the part produced by casting and forming often required further operations such as machining to meet the required specification. The term machining is used to describe various process which involves the removal of material from the workpiece. Okay, this is the introduction part, means the part which is produced by the casting and the forming often required a further operation such as a machining to meet the required specification. The term machining is used to describe various process which involves to removal of material from the workpiece. The term of machining, the term of machining is used to describe various processes which involves removal of materials from workpiece. So here if I am saying of the introduction of our machine tool, so what is going on here? Okay, so here the introduction of is a very important, means the term of machining is used to describe various process which is involves of removal of material from the workpiece. Here this is a very very important. Okay, so this is the point. Okay, we are going for next. After that, we know that there are classifications, means there are three types of classifications are there, means it may be traditional or conventional, abrasive machining and non traditional machining. But all our things are means here machining is a very important point, is a removal of material from the workpiece. It may be a classification if I say of a traditional or conventional machining, abrasive machining, non-traditional machining. Means here what is the way? There are the three different of a classifications are there. Okay, means traditional, if I am saying of a traditional, means sharp cutting tool we are using. See here, if I am saying of a classification, classification of machining process. Okay, if I am speaking about the classification of machining process here, it will be divided into three types. Okay, that is a traditional or conventional, we can say. Next is a abrasive machining, and third one is a non-traditional. Okay, machining process. So here I said of a classification of a machining, means it is divided into three types: traditional, abrasive machining, non-traditional machining. Means here if I am speaking about the traditional, means we are using a sharp cutting tool. We are using of a sharp cutting tool, and the very basic point here of a traditional means the tool is in a contact with the workpiece. Okay, means if I want to remove of a material from the workpiece, the tool should be a contact with the workpiece. So we are saying that is a traditional or conventional machining process here. So it may be a single point cutting tool or it may be a multiple point cutting tool. We can use that one. Okay, If I am speaking about the abrasive machine, means the metal is removed by the action of a hard abrasive of a particles. You have seen of a grinding wheels. So that is the abrasive of a machining process we are saying. Means here the grinding, lapping, honing, this all comes in abrasive. If I am speaking about the traditional, means sharp cutting tool, it may be single point or it may be a multiple point, but is a, means tool is a contact with a workpiece. Example, we can go with the turning process, drilling process, milling process, shaping, broaching. When I am speaking about, see here, when I am saying of examples of a, here I am taking of a turning, or it may be a drilling, or it may be a milling. Okay. Or it may be a shaping. Or it may be a shaping here. So even see here. Or in the same manner, shaping and a broaching. Now coming to the abrasive here. So here the abrasive, if I am speaking about the abrasive, see here, in abrasive we are going for the grinding, we are going for the grinding here, we are going for grinding here in the same manner. Grinding, it may be lapping, it may be honing, okay. So according to this one, we are going for the grinding of, it may be a honing, we are going there. And for non-traditional is a, here, we are going for the, it may be a, see here, it's a honing process. Or it may be a lapping process. For coming to the non-traditional, means some form of energy is take place. It may be a, we can say, it may be a mechanical energy, it may be a chemical energy, it may be electrochemical energy is take place. Example, if I say of a mechanical energy, we can go with the ultrasonic machining. Or in a mechanical, we can also go with the abrasive jet machining. In the same manner, we can go with the electrical EDM, electrical discharge machining, or we can go with the laser beam machining and a chemical blanking. This all comes in a knot. Means we are using some form of energy. It may be mechanical, it may be thermal, it may be electrochemical. There are the different types of a thing we are going for that one. So we can go with this one. These are the things are the classifications, okay. These all are the classification. Now coming to the here is, see here, now coming to the, what is the meaning of machine tool? So here we are very familiar with the, what is the machine? Means any power driven device to design to perform a machining operation are called machine tool. Okay, these are the machine tools. Okay, we are studying about the, what is the metal cutting and the machine tool. So here the metal cutting and the machine tool. Is clear? The machine tool is the definition of a machine tool. A simple definition is here is a, we are going for the, so here we are going for the machine tool is any power driven device designed to perform a machining operation are called machine tool. Functions. Okay, these are the, now the functions is take place here. Okay. Now coming to the here, if I am saying of a, what is a cutting tools? Okay. Means of a, now we come any, a cutting tool is a one or more sharp cutting edge. It may be a single point cutting tool or it may be a multiple point cutting tool. What the, how is the concept of remove? Means work from the, if I am saying this is a example, see here. See, this is my workpiece here. Okay. So I am using as a, this is act as a tool, okay. This is a workpiece here. So this is act as a chip. From the workpiece, so we are, I am using of a single point cutting tool or it may be a multiple point cutting tool. The when a tool is in a contact with the workpiece here, so removal of a material can be take place on the workpiece in the form of chips. The form of chips. Okay. So if I saying of a single point cutting tool, maybe we can go with the turning operation, shaping operation, planing operation. Okay. If I am saying of a single point cutting tool, here if I using of a single point cutting tool, single point cutting tool, what are the operation can be performed here? Means turning operation, or it may be a shaping operation, or it may be a planing operation. Okay, so many are there. Next, for the multiple point cutting tool. So if I am using of a multiple point cutting tool, it may be having a drilling and the milling, drilling and milling operation, and broaching operation also can be performed here. Okay. So up to here is clear. No, now we are going for the what is actually the, see here. Now up to clear here. Now we are going for the what is a cutting tool. So there will be a basic point. We have to remember the things of a what are the introduction part of a this one, and the, what are the definition and what are the classification. Then for the functions, okay, then on the cutting tools. Now come to the cutting tool here. So from the cutting tool of a material, see from there, from the diagram, okay, there will be how the main, what is the continuous shape. So I am using of a single point cutting tool from here, okay. So single point cutting tool here. Now come to the what is the multiple point cutting tool here. In the same manner, see here, what is the turning operation. Okay, depth of, what is the drilling operation can be, what is the milling operation can be performed here from the diagram. Okay, now come to see from the diagram here. See here, now see here, from the single point cutting tool, the removal of material from the workpiece by means of cutting tools which have one major cutting, means see here, one major cutting edge, means I am using of a one single point cutting tool. Single point cutting tool is a major cutting edge point here. Single point cutting tool here. See this diagram. Okay. So even for the boring operation, the boring is operation is also, I am using of a single point cutting tool inside that one. Okay. So here, according to this one, of a removal of metal from the workpiece by means of a cutting tool which have a one major cutting edge. Okay. Now see, just now I said of a single point of a turning operation, boring operation, planing and the shaping. So here if I am saying of a turning operation, this is picked on of a, here is a, can be carried out by the lathe machine, may be carried out by lathe machine here. In the same manner, this is picked on the 3-jaw chuck or 4-jaw chuck. I am feeding of a, in the tool post, I am feeding of a, means here the, I am using of a tool as a single point cutting tool, continuous of a feeder. Okay, from here to this one, this, okay. Now come to the, see here, here the facing on a vertical boring of a machine here. So here also can be taken place here. Okay, boring of a operation means here is a horizontal boring machine. This can be also be carried out in a lathe machine. This also be carried out in a lathe machine when you are fixing of this of a tool in a tailstock. Okay, tailstock, if you are fixing on this one, you can, for the boring, boring means of enlarging of the hole. Already the, with the help of a drill, already hole is performed, as you are enlarging that hole. That is a boring. Okay. By using of a single point cutting tool, we can go with the boring operation. If you fix a hopper, that one is a horizontal of a boring man. Now coming to this one. Okay. The another time, that is a vertical here. Okay. These are the things. Now coming to see here, there will be having another one is a planing and the shaping. Here also we are fixing here. See, this is a, if I am saying, the production of a flat surface on a planar. Planar means we are means here the very important, the difference. Okay, I am also saying the difference is here the tool is fixed, means tool is act as a stationary. Tool is act as a stationary. Okay, and stationary even in a boring also, tool is act as a stationary. Clear? Now coming to the, in a, see here, just we are giving a few, even for the planar, the tool is act as a stationary, same, tool is act as a stationary. So So according to this one, see here, now come to shaping, tool is a movable here. The tool is movable in a shaping. Tool is movable. Means it will move forward and the backward here. But we are using of a, it may be a, what you call as a, in a lathe machine, or it may be a internal boring and the, of a, and the internal boring of horizontal vertical, we are using of a single point cutting tool. The planing also single point cutting is shaping. Here you are using of a single point cutting tool. Okay, but here only the same thing is that this one of a lathe is also a tool, is act as a stationary, and the tool is also act as a stationary. In a planing is also tool is act, only in a shaping the tool is movable. Forward stroke is act as a cutting stroke and the backward stroke is act as a idle stroke. Okay, clear? But we are using all this of a four things are turning, boring, planing and the shaping are a single point cutting tool here. Now coming to the multiple point cutting tool here. See here, the multiple point cutting tool we are using as a, see here, the surface, slots, blind or through a hole of a drill here. And for the broaching of a multiple point here, this is act as a multiple point, okay, this is a multiple point here, this is also. And for the, see here, this will be a vertical of a multiple point cutting tool. So, this of a reaming, form of a cutting, dovetail. Means, the here we are using a removal of metal from the workpiece by means of cutting tools which have a two or more major cutting edge, that is a multiple point cutting tool. That is a multiple point cutting tool we are saying. So this type of operation can be take place here. Especially for the milling we are using and for the drilling, for a broaching purpose, we are using of a multiple point cutting tool here. And now come to the, what is a single point cutting tool here. See here, the very important part of a single point of a cutting tool, okay. The chip of material is removed from the workpiece, removed from the surface of the workpiece. Means I said of a, means the chip of a material is removed from the surface of the workpiece like this. From the, this is act as a workpiece here. This is a chip and this is the help of, this is a act as a tool. Okay, this is act as a reference line. Now this is the, see here, the single point of a cutting tool means the chip of material is removed from the surface of the workpiece. Means here we are using of a cutting speed, that is a V, okay, and the depth of cut, it may be a W or it may be a D, or it may feed is a F, and the time is required means of a one cylinder to surface of the length, means here, okay, this one, rotation cabinet, means here, see here, where N is the number of revolution of the workpiece per second here, per second here. So here for the T is equal to, we are calculating of a, what is the time taken by the, here, by the F into A, feed into A by number of a revolution of the workpiece. So we are calculating this one, Monty, okay. Here the time required for this one, we are calculating on this one. Now coming to this one, see here, from this one we are going for the, what is actually the distance moved in a one revolution, or it may be a, means the depth we are saying, okay, depth we are saying, that is the depth, okay. We are going for the depth, distance moved in a one revolution, of a, here we are saying of a feet of a thickness here, okay. In the same matter of a rate of material removal here, so this is the, means surface speed of a can be taken place here. Depth of cut here, the simple here, okay, means the, if I am saying of a depth of cut is a simple concept of here is how much, means the distance between of a, here the uncut to the cut, uncut to the, distance between of a uncut to the cut here, that is the distance between of a, difference of a uncut to the cut, that is a depth we are saying of it, that is a single point cutting tool, okay. Now coming to the two cutting tool of a material, they are having a different types of a cutting tools, we know that one. Means it should be a cutting should, tool should be harder compared to the cutting tools, material should be harder compared to the workpiece of a materials here. Then only the easily can be removed from the, means the removal of a material can be from the workpiece, can be easily can be removed. So that is the basic points here, okay. Now if I am saying of a here, see, the cutting tool of a material means it may be having a lathe tool bit generally made up of 5 materials. It may be high carbon steel, okay. If I am saying of a, that is a high carbon of a speed steel, cast iron such as a steelite, cemented carbide, ceramic, experiments, the more accepted of a finding of a wide use of a bronzer and the polycrystalline of a diamond shear. So we are using a different types of tool, cutting tool of a material. There are different types of a materials are here. If I am saying of a lathe of a tool bits, of a properties, if a lathe is there, so what happened if an example of a lathe tool bits, maybe we have seen that one, it may be hard, wear resistance here, it may be a hard, it may be a wear resistant, capable of a maintaining of a red hardness, means at the, what happened, there will be heat is there, it produces on that one, okay. So when the almost of a strength is known, so it will be forms of a red hardness, capable of maintaining that one. Sometimes it will be a break take place here. So during the machining operation, so we have to know that one, there is a capable of maintaining, means it can, hardness can be taken place, strong enough, means ability of a cutting tool is to maintain sharp cutting of a edge even when turns to a become of a red because of their high heat and the during the cutting operation. Able to withstand, just now I said, okay, means with a high of a heat is taken place here, means high depth, if I go, means what happens, the tool gets of a very very red in a hardness, it becomes of it, and even it should be a withstand the shock during the cuttings, vibration should be, and shape to so edge can be printed of the work can be taken place, that is of a tool, means tool should having a properties of it be a very very hard compared to the workpiece here, so that the machining operation can be taken place, otherwise tool gets break here. Now coming to the high speed of a steel of a tool bits is a, it may contain of a tungsten, see here it may be a constant of a tungsten, or it may be a chromium, it may be a vanadium, it may be a molybdenum, it may be a cobalt. These are the high speed steel of a tool bit of their composition, and by having a heavy cuts, means they can combine with the, means high speed steel, HSS also we are saying, means here HSS, that is a means of a combination of this one, means tungsten, chromium, vanadium, okay, this and molybdenum and a cobalt, and it's having a high strength, 90% of it we are using of a in a lathe machine of a single point cutting tool of a this type of a tool only, high speed steel only, and which can of a see here, which can withstand of a shock and the sharp under the red heat, and a generally of a two types, that is a molybdenum and the tungsten of a base here, and cobalt is added if a more red hardness is desired here. Now coming to the cemented of a, this all are the different types of a tool bits are, okay, these are the cemented carbide of a tool bits, means which can having a capable of a, means here the, it is having a 3 to 4 times higher than the speed steel, nothing but a high speed steel. This cemented of a carbide of a tool bits is a high speed of a, nothing but a having high strength of a, nothing but a 3 to 4 times of a higher of a high speed steel, and a low toughness but high hardness take place here, and excellent of a red hardness here. According to that, consists of a tungsten of a carbide sintering in the cobalt of a metric, and a straight tungsten used to machine of a cast iron. You know the, what is the beauty of the cast iron here, 90% of our machines are made up of cast iron here. For machining of a cast iron, we are using of a cemented carbide tool bit, and for the non-ferrous of a material like a chatter of a easily, means non-ferrous of a material means it will be a not containing of a iron materials here, and a different grades of different works here, different types of a work, we are different types of a grade we are using on that one. Coated of a carbide tool means the same way we are going for the coated carbide of a tool bit is the same thing of a deposing of a thin layer of a wear resistant of a titanium of a nitrate, titanium of a carbide, aluminium oxide on the cutting edge of the tool. Means here all the same thing of a coated of a carbide of a, here is also a some type of a, means a deposition, means made up of a combination of resistance of a titanium nitrate, titanium carbide, aluminium oxide here, and even also here we are increasing an lubricity and improve the here improving the here, see here we are even we are going for to improve this one, see here. We are also improving the this one, means of a wear resistant of a, see here, up to a 200% to a 500% here, and even the lower breakage of a resistant also up to a 20% here. So there is a beauty of this one is here, see here, the coated of a carbide tool bit is the same, is a very beauty of a here, means here improves the wear resistant of a 200% to a 500% here, and the breakage of resistance up to a 20%. Provides a longer life, increase the cutting speed. And a titanium coated of offer of a wear resistance at a lower speed, ceramics and a coated for the high speeds here. Okay. And the ceramic of a tool bits here, see here, same thing here. Ceramics of a tool bits means permit of a high cutting speed, increase the tool life. So in the better surface finishing can be a carbide than of a carbide here. Okay, in the same manner, weaker than the carbide used in a shock free and a lower of a shock of a situation. Especially it is used in a ceramics we are using here. Okay, in the same way, see here, it will be without of a metallic bond agent and such as the cobalt and the aluminum of a oxide, most properly additive of it. And here, okay. So here also we are using some types of a, this type of a things. We are going for the call it as in a grinding operation. We are using some types of a, this one. Now coming to the here, the diamond. You know the diamond. The diamond of a tool bit is mainly of a machine of a non-ferrous of a materials here. And abrasive, especially for the glass cutting, we are also using here diamonds. Even that is a single crystal of a nature of a natural of a diamonds here. High wear, but a low shock resistance of a factor here. Polycrystalline, here diamonds are taken place here. And the here also the polycrystalline faces of a, that is a, what you call as a, means of a poly, means of a, plastics made of that one, okay. Means it may be a thermoplastic or it may be thermosetting also we can say. So that type of a can be carried out, means it can be cut with the help of this diamond of a tool bits here. Tin of a manufacturing of a diamond fused of a together and the bonded of a suitable of a carbide and the started here. There are the different types of a tool bits here. Now come to the very very important point is a chip formation. Just now I said of a chip formation is a simple thing, is a chip formation here. Now before going to this one, so what is actually the chip formation? Okay, see here. The chip formation is a, if I say that is a types of chips also we can say. So what is going with the chip formation here? See here, if I am saying of a, before going to that one, let's chip, that is a chip, okay, that is a chip formation. Okay, so here I am doing of a rough diagram here. See here, the rough diagram same just like of a, see, there is a workpiece here, okay, and this is a tool which I am doing here, tool. Okay, now coming to the, this is a reference line. Okay, now this is act as a, see here. Okay, this is a reference line, or we can say that is a shear plane. Okay, this is act as a chip, and this is act as a workpiece here. Okay, here I am saying of a, see, this is act as a, if this is angle is a 5, and this is a, if I am saying of a P Q R S, okay, P Q R S. So here how the chip formation is a taken place here. Okay, this chip formation can be taken place here. Now see here, see, so simple thing it is a, if I am saying of a, there will be a orthogonal cutting or it may be a shaping in which workpiece is remains as a stationary. I am saying of a, this is a workpiece is act as a stationary. This is act as a stationary here. Okay. If I am saying of a, this is act as a stationary and the tool is movable here. Tool is act as a movable. Okay. So if I am saying of a tool is a movable here. Okay. When I am saying of a tool is act as a movable here, means it represents of a orthogonal of a cutting, means or a shaping in which workpiece is remain as a stationary and the tool is act as a movable. Tool is act as a movable here. So what happened here? the act towards the workpiece from the left. Okay. Now the metal in front of the tool, metal in front of the tool means the workpiece in front of the tool gets compressed and very severely caused as a shear stress. When a metal of a workpiece is coming off against of the tool gets of a compressed very severely cause of a shear stress. Okay, this stress is a maximum along a plane. This is maximum along a plane. That is called as a shear plane. This is a maximum along the plane. That is a shear plane. The material of the workpiece is a ductile. The material of the workpiece is a ductile. I am using as a, this workpiece is act as a ductile of a material. Okay. And flows a plastically along the shear plane. Means whatever when a tool is a contact with the workpiece here, which is act as a stationary. Example, this is having a saying example of a this is a shaping operation. So tool is a movable, I said also before also the tool is a contact with the workpiece very severely cause of a shear plane here. By using of a ductile of a material here. Means here what happened here, see here from PQRS, PQRS. So metal structure starts getting elongated along the line PQ, along the line here is along the line PQ. Okay. Here the material gets of a elongated. Okay. Means here starts gets elongated along the line of a PQ here. So the PQ below the shear plane, which is a shear below the shear plane and the continuous up to the RS, that is above the shear plane we are saying. Okay. When complete deformation of area is represented, okay, by PQRS. If I am saying of a, this is a PQRS, see here, PQRS. So here in between, I am saying this is a shear plane, okay. So here is a machine take place here, see here. So what happened when complete deformation of area is represented by PQRS, okay, within which the metal deformation occur, which is known as a shear zone, which is known as a, this is act as a shear zone, this total portion is called as a shear zone, that is a, yeah. Is act as a shear zone, PQRS is act as a, that is a shear zone, okay. Now, the coming to the content between the shear zone will be having a, which shape this is a, I am also saying this is also a, shear zone having a wedge shape, it is a also a wedge shape with a thicker portion near to the tool, thicker portion is near to the tool and thinner portion is opposite to it. This shape of a shear zone is one of the reasons due to which chip skulls will form here. You know that one chip skulls is there, chip skulls will form here. Means here, you know that one, continuous of a chip, what happened here? Will form like of a chip skulls will be formed here. Okay. So here according to this one, what happened here? Chip skulls will be formed. It means it like this. Chips are continuous, chips will be formed like. So dip from this one, what happened? Skulls will be formed like. Means it will be a ribbon shape like that one. Okay. So it will be having a chip. Means what happened? Production of a chip is very hot and safe to disposal is very necessary. Okay, is clear? Now see here, the simple point here I am saying here is a, there will be having a, when it is a, I am using of a, what we call as a, see here, when I am using as a, this is, see here, once again I am drawing here, okay, this is act as a tool, this is a chip, so this shape, okay, this is called as a shear zone, it may be a wedge shape, okay, So this is a this chip, okay, and this is act as a workpiece here. The production of a chip is very very hot and safe to disposable is very nil. You know that which is when a tool is contact with the workpiece, that which is coming out in the form of a chip is very very hot and is very important to disposable as soon as possible here. Okay. Now coming to the there is a different types of a chips. Okay. See here there will be having a different types of a chip formation here. See from the chip formation, very conventional machining of a process, removal of a formation of a chip. Chip formation is a complex phenomena where a force is applied to the workpiece to remove of a material from the workpiece. The metal is a shear along the shear plane which makes an angle alpha. Just now I showed of a which makes an angle alpha here. Which makes an angle alpha here. Okay. Which makes an angle alpha. Okay. And with the direction of a tool travel because of a shear zone. Now coming to the chip formation. How the chip formation? It is having a three types of a chip formation. So types of a chips can be means due to the gist of a having a means that is a chip formation is a it may be having a shape of the shape and the size of a chip obtained here. Okay. See here. The chip means here the types of a chips. Okay, the how the this one is a chip formation means that will be depend upon the see here. Yeah, that is a mainly depend upon the shape, size, and it may be having a the chip is obtained depends on the types of a material. It may be ductile, it may be brittle, to be cut and other cutting of a conditions. According to the cutting condition, it is also indicate the types and the quality of a workpiece. The following three basics of a types of a chips are produced in a any convention of a machining of a process. If I am saying of a conventional machining process, that's come in a classification means two should be a contact with the workpiece. That is a conventional machining process. Okay, it may be having a three type, that is a segmental, discontinuous shape, or continuous shape, or continuous shape with a build up edge here. Okay, these are the three types of a chips can be taken place here. Okay, means we are saying of a depend upon the cutting condition. That's a very very important here is a if I am saying that is a types of a chips can be occurred. Types of a chips can be occurred is a very main shape, that is the size, and the that is a depend upon the types of material and the cutting other cutting conditions. It may be having that is a size of a that may be a tool geometry or it may be quality of the workpiece here. And the what is the feed, depth of cut, and the cutting fluids here. Okay, that all comes in a here the types and the quality workpiece. The and these are the which is nothing but a for the we are having a three type. It may be a having a very careful listen here. The types of a chip, it may be a segmental or a discontinuous shape. It may be having a segmental or discontinuous shape. It may be a continuous shape, with a build up edge. These are the things that take place here. Okay, these are the diagrams also given here. Now we are going for the individual level. Okay, see here. Now if I am saying of a discontinuous of a chips here, see here means segmental chips also I can say here. If I am see here, I am drawing a rough diagram for this one. Okay, see here. Sorry. Now coming to the here, if I am for the discontinuous shape, see here, for especially for the discontinuous shape, this types of a means here chips is produced when a machining of a brittle material here. Brittle material. Let's before going to that one, let's with the means here. See, this is a discontinuous shape means not a continuous means here. Okay, this is my work material and this is a tool. So this is a rough diagram for that is a tool. Okay, now there will be having a chip which is nothing but a chip is coming out and this is act as a workpiece here. So this we are using of a brittle material means the discontinuity of a chip here, discontinuity of a chip, this is a from the fear, okay. Tool against of the workpiece, the chip is coming out in the form of a segmental or it may be discontinuous ways, okay. Due to this workpiece, I am using of a brittle material. Brittle material here, such as if I am saying of a brittle material, it may be having a cast iron. See here, this is a brittle material. It may be a cast iron, brass or casting here, okay. So, here I am using of a lower rake angle, that is a smaller rake angle also we can say here, even with a what we call as a low ductile of a material, segmental of a chip in it. Due to of a low speed, high depth of cut and while cutting of a ductile of a material here. Means here, what happened here, this type of a chip is consists of a separated, plastically deformed segment which loosely wear to each other or completely unconnected here. These are produced by actually fracture of the metal head of the cutting edge, we can say. The fracture of the metal takes place when the magnitude of the compression forces reaches the fracture limit of the metals here. In the same manner, we can also say the chips are broken into a small segment instead of a plastic flow of chip. Means the chips are broken, means chips are broken into a small segments here. This is a small segment instead of a plastic flow of continuous of chips here. So here the coefficient of a friction between the coefficient between the friction between the here chip and the tool is very high. Most of the heat is generated due to this one. What happened? Most of the heat is generated and carried by the chip and the tool is heated to a lower temperature and tool life is longer here. Okay, this all take the circumstances of this one. Okay, so here we are going for the, this is a discontinuous of a chip here. Now coming to the continuous of a chip here. So if I am speaking about the continuous, see from the diagram also the continuous of a chip, how is coming from the this diagram here. See here, this is the continuous of a chip. How the continuous of a chip can be taken place is this portion is a continuous of a chip. This portion, so this is act as of a continuous of a chip here. Okay, so how the continuous of a chip is taken place, means here the continuous of a chip I am using here is a ductile of a material here, like steel, copper, aluminium, etc. Means due to the first is a ductile of a material, it may be a low carbon steel, okay, it may be a copper, it may be aluminium, okay, that is the ductile of a material. And even the very important point here is a larger rake angle. Larger rake angle here. And high cutting speed, sharp cutting edge and efficient cutting fluid, lower friction between the tool face and the chip. There is a high in the discontinuous here. Now see here, this one what happened here? This type of a chip produced when the material ahead of the tool continuously deform without fracture. And the flow of a rake angle phase in the form of a continuous of a segment here. The following factors are responsible for continuous of a chip. Due to this all circumstances, this is the problem. Means it may be a ductile material, it may be a cutting speed should be high, it may be a larger rake angle, it may be a sharp cutting edge and the efficient of a cutting of a fluids here. So this all comes here, okay. And the tool face here. Means continuous chips are desirable because of a smooth surface will be obtained here. And they are also help in a providing a higher tool life and the lower power consumption here. Higher tool life and the lower power consumption. Long continuous chips can also get a problem at the, so that as soon as possible it should be, chip should get disposable. This problem can be solved by providing a, means due to this here. See this one, if a continuous chip is taken place here. So what happens, this continuous chip is taken place here. Continuous chip is here. Means it should be a harmful to the machine. So as soon as possible, it should be disposable. Another is a advance of this one, we can go with the chip breakers here. So that chip breaker means by using that one, we are breaking into a small pieces of a removal can be easily can be taken place. That is the reason we are going for the chip breaker. Then this one. Okay. Now come to the continuous chip with the build-up edge. If I am speaking of a continuous chip with the build-up edge, see here, this is very important here is a. So here it takes place here. See here. This portion continues with the build-up edge. Here is a build-up edge. B-U-E also we can see. Okay, build-up edge. So So how it can be taken place here due to the shear, especially due to of a, because of high friction between the work and the material with tool. So build-up edge is formed by owning of a action of a welding of chip material on the tool point. Here is a tool point. Welding can be taken place here. Okay. Welding of a chip point can be occurred here. Welding can be taken place here. Okay. Welding of chips can be taken place. That is a build-up edge will be formed. So here how it can be? These types of a chips are, we are saying, undesirable because this is result in a higher power consumption, poor surface finishing, high tool wear and reduction in the tool life here. So here the simple thing is the build-up edge is formed with the machining of a same here also by using of a ductile of a material. Here I have to use, due to this one of a ductile material, it can be which contain of a smaller rake angle, smaller rake angle, ductile of a material with a smaller rake angle, we have to use that one of at a lower cutting speed here. The other condition which gives of a rise of a build-up edge is just now I said of a higher value, feed, depth of cut, high friction can be taken place here. In the same manner, what happened here? We are going for the poor lubrication, high cutting process, temperature on the shear zone. So here build-up edge is caused. Means how it can be caused? Just now I said due to this one of a welding of a, due to what happened? It is a caused, means due to the under the action of a pressure and the temperature. Pressure and temperature we can also say. Pressure and the temperature to the face of the tool. That is the reason welding of the chips can be material on the tool point can be high friction and the between tool and the work material with the tool can be taken. And the build-up edge is eventually swept off from the work and remain attached to the material surface. That is it. Welding can be take place of the chips on the tool here. Okay. Due to that one, what happened? Poor surface finishing and due to the of a power, high power consumption can be taken and is a not harmful while of a rough machine. For a rough finishing, we can go with the, this type of a tool here. Is clear? Now see here. Before going to the chip breaker, let we discuss about the shear. If see here, before going to the chip breaker, we should be aware of this one. See here, first very important, we have to write what is the types of a chips here and how it can means what are the work material we are using here and what are the what we got as a feed and how, what is the rake angle should be taken place. So we should be aware of that one. Okay. So let's we see here. If I am saying of a, that is a type of chips, okay, and what is the work material, if I am taking of a, what is the work material, according to the, what is the cutting speed, and what is the feed, and what is the rake angle, if I am speaking about that one. So we should be aware of that one. Okay. So if I am saying of a, see here, the first thing, if I am saying of a continuous shape, okay, if I am using of a continuous shape, so what is the material we have to use? That will be a ductile of a material. We have to use of a ductile material. Cutting speed should be a high and the feed should be a small and the rake angle should be a large. In the same manner, for a continuous chip with the build-up edge, continuous chip with build-up edge, so we are using here as a material is the same thing of it, that is a ductile of a material, and the cutting speed we are using as a medium and the feed we are using as a high and the rake angle is a small. In the same manner, if you are going for the discontinuous or a segmental of a chips here, discontinuous chips. We are using of a material, work material, we are using as a brittle material, and the cutting speed should be a low and the feed should be a high and the rake angle should be a small. So these things we have to be in a mind of this type of a things can means there is a types of a chips. It may be a continuous chips, or it may be a, see here, it may be a continuous chip. For the continuous chip, it may be ductile of a material, cutting speed should be high and the feed should be small and the rake angle should be a large. Continuous chip is the build-up edge. We are using of a ductile material, same material, cutting speed should be a medium. We are going with the feed is the high and the rake angle is a small. Okay. And now come to the discontinuous of a chip. Brittle material we are using here. Cutting speed should be a low and the speed should be as high. And the here we are using of a smaller rake angle, single point of it. Okay. Now coming to the last one is a, what is the meaning of here is a chip breaker. Now if I am speaking about the chip breakers, what is the use of chip breakers here? See here from the chip breaker, what is the use of the chip breakers here is, we are see from the diagram, is a first one is a here, if I am saying here, this is a action of a chip breakers. Okay, the chip is a breaking of a decreasing the radius of the curvature of the chip. Here is a radius of this one, we are decreasing here. Okay, that is a chip breaker I am using here, first one. And here, and the second one is a clamping type here, B1 is a clamping type you are using here. Now another one is a here, the rake face is a radius, it may be a positive rake, it may be a zero rake here. What is actually that this chip breaker is actually, first of all, means the chip tends to flow over the face of the tool as a ribbon. You have seen, it will be a flow like ribbons, okay, when your continuous chip is taken place in the ribbon shape. So here initially it will be a state, and then what happened, the ribbon which is initially a state gradually changes to a spiral. Gradually it is a changes to the, after initially it will be a ribbon type, okay, then after it will be a changes to the spiral. Means see here, this is at a, initially what happened here, this is a ribbon in shape, then is a initially, okay, then after that what happened here, it will go to the spiral. Okay, these chips are difficult to handle. Means this type of a chip, this type of a chips is very very difficult to handle that one. So what happened here, danger, and even is a dangerous to the operator. The chip breakers are used to present the formation of a long unmagnetable of a chips. So that is the reason there are a ground into a face of the this one, and or additional pieces clamped to the tool. So here that is the reason we are going for the ground type. It may be having a chip breaker, we a clamp type, we a step type we are using here. So different types of a chip. It may be a, see, just now I said of a chip breakers here. So here the groove on the tool face. If I am saying here, see example the diagram of a, already you have seen this one diagram. Okay. So what happens is the groove type means here chip breaker is a taken place here. Okay, in this type. Okay, we can also, that is a groove type also we can say here. This type of a things are. So here, why it means the groove on the tool face is the forms of a chip into the